Good morning, everyone. I am Vasudharani Devanathan, Assistant Professor, Department of Biology. A warm welcome to all of you on the occasion of the first convocation of Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, Tirupati. Namaste, Bharatiya Vigyan, Siksha Evam Anusandhan Sansthan ke Pratham Dikshant Samaroh mein aap sabhi ka hardik swagat hai. Due to the prevailing pandemic situation, we are organizing this function in a virtual mode. Warm welcome to all our guests, colleagues, parents, students, and most importantly, the first batch of 35 graduating students for your virtual presence in the function. We request all students and guests to please switch off your mobile phones, keep your microphones muted, and your camera off during the entire event. I repeat, please keep your mobile phones switched off, microphones muted, and your camera off during the entire event. To warm up for the occasion, we will now take you through a brief video on the highlights of the short history of ICER Tirupati from its beginnings in 2015.
Nestled among the picturesque range of the Tirumala Hills is the bustling city of Tirupati, surrounded by rich flora and fauna. With Tirupati being chosen as one of the 100 cities to be developed under the Smart Cities Mission by the Government of India, the Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, ICER Tirupati, is one such institute that has been administered and set up by the Ministry of Human Resource Development, now renamed as Ministry of Education, along with another institute, the Indian Institute of Technology, IIT Tirupati, on the science and technology front. The foundation stone of ICER Tirupati was laid on 28 March 2015 by the then Union Minister for Human Resource Development, Srimati Smriti Irani, at Yerpedu Mandal, about 30 kilometers from the city center, along with that of IIT and IIIT. With an initial strength of about 10 faculty members, the institute began the intake of its first batch of approximately 45 undergraduate students that very academic year. Over these 5 years, the institute has grown in number, with each incumbent batch of students to now have about 650 in total and 50 faculty members at present. ICER Tirupati is proud to have achieved an almost equal gender ratio among students through the years. The institute has meticulously charted programs and coursework for students who aspire to pursue an integrated BSMS course at the undergraduate level, integrated master's and PhD programs, PhD programs, and positions for postdoctoral research. The courses available to the students have variety and depth, with faculty at the institute drawn from diverse areas of specialization. These courses are a blend of lectures and laboratory sessions to incorporate a research-based component while learning the subjects. The institute now offers more than 150 courses across various disciplines, and students have full freedom to mix and match courses to suit their interests. The UG lab courses are supplemented by carefully designed experiments and the necessary laboratory equipment, with a focus on strengthening basic concepts in science and also allowing the students to explore their curiosity at the same time. The library at ICER Tirupati is a storehouse of information, catering to the varied interests and requirements that each one has, with about 8,000 books, 2,000 plus e-journals and 7 databases, along with 40 print journals and magazines in numerous fields and genres with online accessibility.
To further support the deep-rooted, research-driven learning culture on campus, UG students have access to state-of-the-art research facilities set up at the institute. These include NMR, mass spectrometry, confocal microscopy, single-molecule force spectrometer, cell culture lab, and other equipment required to carry out frontline research. The institute has witnessed a constant rise in the number of research publications in various international journals of high repute. Some of these publications even include BSMS students as co-authors, on work based on their semester projects. Even during the pandemic lockdown, the Institute has combated the problem in its own way, contributing to enhancing publications, exploring innovative teaching methods, and organizing several webinars. In the area of students' research and innovation, one of the notable mentions would be about the IGEM team of ISO Tirupati, which bagged a gold medal for their project Coca-Cola at the International Competition on Synthetic Biology, IGEM, held at Boston last year.
The Institute holds regular colloquia with eminent researchers from across the globe for effective exchange of scientific ideas and research. Some such personalities include Professor Serge Haroche, a French physicist who received the Nobel Prize in the year 2012, and Professor Richard N. Zaire from Stanford, who is internationally recognized for his work in spectroscopy. The Institute has hosted various seminars, conferences, and workshops like the Intercity Number Theory Seminar, National Symposium on Avian Biology, Mass Spectrometry Symposium, Workshop on Data Analysis and Machine Learning, the Annual Meeting of the Astronomical Society of India, and the International Symposium in Chemical Biology, to name a few. Popularization of science and public outreach are some aspects that the Institute has always laid a strong emphasis on. The ongoing research from each department at the Institute is shared among the students and faculty through events such as Physics Day, A Day of Life, and the Chemistry Day. With a vision to encourage women scientists on campus and inspire students, the Institute celebrates Women's Day by hosting various programs that include inviting women researchers and achievers from science and entrepreneurial fields and also participating in international efforts with the IUPAC. All these events have culminated into Veekshana, a forum to empower women scientists on campus. To make the process of learning science a joyous experience, the Institute organizes a Science Day on the 28th of February each year. Students set up innovative and creative demonstrations illustrating concepts and ideas that they find exciting. Children from the nearby schools also participate in this event, which also has several themed talks. Being home to a confluence of students from various social and cultural landscapes from across the country, the Institute celebrates various festivals such as Onam, Holi, Ugadi, Ganesh Chaturthi, and Diwali. Vivante, the science and cultural festival of ISER Tirupati, is a tryst of 3 days of unabated expression of students' talents which are explored through a myriad of events and activities. There are a number of student-run clubs active on campus which are mentored by faculty coordinators. Subject-specific clubs like Biovision, Birding and Trekking Club, Celestic, Schrodinger's Kittens, Synergy, and the Math Club aim to improve students' collective understanding of the subjects. Other clubs such as the Literary Club, Anubhuti, the Classical Arts Club, Jijivisha, the Drama Club, and Fovia, the Photography Club, helps enhance their creative skills and has played a major role in shaping a close-knit environment on campus. The Sports Club helps maintain a balance between physical and mental health and mold students' personalities. The club frequently organizes both indoor and outdoor sports tournaments. Unnati, a student's initiative, is actively involved in community outreach in and around the Institute. The program encompasses several activities, including setting up libraries and conducting workshops for students in government schools. Many of these activities were initiated by the first batch of students, BSMS 2015. Being the pioneer batch of ISER Tirupati, they have collectively witnessed the environment on campus evolve and grow through its timeline. As the batch of BSMS 2015 graduates this year, here is what some of them have to say about their journey through these 5 years.
When I first came to ISER Tirupati, I was a bit flummoxed, to put it mildly, for when Tirupati was just a town, not a big city like Pune.
And with the help of Dr. Vasudha and my friend Karthik, we started Unnati, the outreach activity club of our institute, which most of you might be aware of. It initially catered to the need of the students living in the nearby villages. Similar to Unnati, Birding Club was also started by a few of my batchmates, including me, along with the support of Dr. Robin and Dr. Nandini, when we were being taught ecology and evolution course in the third semester.
It has been quite a gratifying experience to contribute to the Institute's growth academically as well as non-academically. I would like to thank ISET Tirupati for giving me an opportunity to organize SPIKMAKE events, to volunteer for that. And honestly, I had no experience in organizing events before coming to ISET, and I have learned quite a lot through that process. So thank you, ISET, for that.
So now when I look back the 5 years, I think being a first batch, not just as students, but then the faculty, administrative staff, security and warden aunties, everybody who were present over there, we all went through a unique experience.
I want to thank the institute for recommending me for Khurana Fellowship, which I was awarded in 2018, along with my friend Dipin. Thank you so much.
I would like to say that ISET life was an era, and I would like to carry this ISET tag as a legacy with great pleasure.
Construction of the permanent campus in progress, world-class facilities are being set up in terms of research, teaching, student hostels and recreation. This will add to the concerted efforts being directed towards establishing ISET Tirupati as a premier research and education hub. The pioneer batch graduating today has had a cascading influence on all the batches that have joined thereafter. This butterfly effect, along with the dynamic interactions between the students and faculty, has given the necessary impetus for the promise that the defining motto of the institute, creating infinite possibilities, is certainly a possibility.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first convocation of the institute is about to commence. The academic procession will now be entering the hall. We request all of you in the hall to please rise and remain standing till all the members in the academic procession are seated.
Thank you.
welcome to the first convocation of the Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, Tirupati. Today, we are honored to have Dr. K. Kasturi Rangan, eminent space scientist, former chairman of the Indian Space Research Organization, and the chairman of the drafting committee, New Education Policy 2020, as the chief guest for this convocation. A very warm welcome to you, sir. We are delighted to welcome Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Secretary, Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, and Chairperson, Board of Governors, ISA Tirupati, who will preside over the convocation proceedings. A warm welcome to you too, sir. It gives us immense pleasure to also welcome Sri Amit Khare, IAS, Secretary, Department of Higher Education, Ministry of Education, Government of India, and Member of the Board of Governors, ISA Tirupati. A very warm welcome to you also, sir. Now, I request Dr. Mohan Kumar, Registrar ISA Tirupati, to commence the proceedings.
Good morning and welcome to you all. I request Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Chairperson, Board of Governors of ISA Tirupati, to declare the convocation open.
I declare the first convocation of ISA Tirupati open.
The award of degrees, prizes, and medals will now commence. I request Professor Gauri Ambika, Coordinator Academic Programs, to present the candidates for the award of BS and MS degree, and Professor Krishna N. Ganesh, Chairperson Senate, to admit them. Ma'am, over to you.
I, the coordinator of academic programs, present to you, sir, 35 students, including those in absentia, who have completed the prescribed courses of study and have been declared eligible to be awarded both the degrees of Bachelor of Science and Master of Science. I pray that they be admitted to the said degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the director and chairperson of the Senate of ISA Tirupati, I admit the candidates presented, including those in absentia, to the degrees of Bachelor of Science and Master of Science of the Institute with all the honors, rights, and privileges, and expect them to be worthy of the same.
I will now call out the names of the graduating students being awarded Bachelor of Science and Master of Science degrees one by one. The photograph of the student and the degree certificates will be displayed on the screen. Jasin K. Babu. Anubhav Thar. Apichit Behra. Vankanavat Aruna Bai. Rafna Rafiq. Kavita UK. Abjashri S. Dania Devasi. Karthik Srivatsan. Aditya R. Dibin Baby. Jiten Chandar B. Shinde Nikita Neelkant. Revati Sajeev. Nandita V. Nair. She is awarded BS and MS degrees with distinction. Joshi, Swapnil, Sanjay. Shijisha, AC. Harikrishnan, CP. Pawar, Sonali, Shivaji. Ashwin, PV. Renadeep Roy, he is awarded BS and MS degrees with distinction. Pillai Kaushal Jayakumar. NS Chiranjeevi. Aditya Kulkarni, he is getting BS and MS degrees with distinction. Abhiya R. Nabadeep Chowdhury. Narola Harsh Bharat Pai. Shubham Sinha. Parth Rajoria. Anakha Balakrishnan. Vishwanath KG. Jalaja Madhusudhanan, she is getting BS and MS degrees with distinction. Pranav Unnikrishnan. Jayamol P. And Vaishak BR.
Let me congratulate all the students who graduated today, and I wish you all the best and a bright future.
Thank you, sir.
The Chairperson Board of Governors, Professor Ashutosh Sharma, has signed the register of graduates. This may please be displayed.
Professor Gauri Ambika, Coordinator Academic Programs, will now present the candidates for Award of Institute's Gold Medal and the prize for the Best Graduating Student.
The Institute Gold Medal is awarded to the student who tops the BSMS batch by securing the highest cumulative grade point average or CGPA. For the award of the Institute Gold Medal in 2020, I present you, sir, Mr. Renadeep Roy. Renadeep Roy has an outstanding academic record all through the BSMS program. Out of 53 courses he credited, he secured A plus for 39 courses and A for 12 courses. He was awarded the Institute's Academic Excellence Prize in 4 semesters and the CNR Rao Education Foundation Prize in 2 semesters. He tops his batch with a CGPA of 9.6 on a scale of 10 with physics as his special subject. During his study at ISER Tirupati, Renadeep read projects in theoretical and computational condensed matter physics at IIT Roper and IIT Madras under the Summer Research Fellowship Program of Indian Academy of Sciences. During his fifth year project, he worked on classical aspects of supersymmetric conformal field theories at IMSC Chennai with Professor Venkata Surya Narayana Nemani as his guide. His future research interests are in the areas related to condensed matter physics and high energy physics. I request our chief guest, Dr. Kasturi Dengan, to present the gold medal and the certificate of merit.
Congratulations, Renadeep Roy, and best wishes for a bright future.
prize for the best graduating student is awarded to the student with excellence performance in academics and extracurricular activities. The award comes with a certificate of merit and a prize money. I present you, sir, Ms. Jalaja Mathusudhanan, for the award of the prize for the best graduating student in 2020. Ms. Jalaja Mathusudhanan completed BSMS program with Inspire Scholarship, securing a CGPA of 9.1 with distinction. She has chosen biology as her special subject. During the course of her study, she did summer projects in IIT Chennai and NCBS Bangalore under Indian Academy Science Summer Fellowship Program. She was selected for the very competitive Corona Fellowship and worked in a project at St. Louis University, USA. During her final year of study, Ms. Jalaja did her MS thesis on characterization of microglial response to cortical stab injury in NCBS Bangalore with Dr. Hia Ghosh. She has actively participated in many extracurricular activities during her studies, especially in Bio Club and Science Day celebrations. She already has a research publication in the journal Brain and Behavior. I request our chief guest, Dr. Kasturi Rengan, to present the certificate of merit to her.
Congratulations, Ms. Jalaja Mathusudhanan, and best wishes for a bright future.
Thank you, sir.
Director Aisa Tirupati, Professor Krishna N. Ganesh, will now present the report of the Institute.
Respected Dr. Kasturi Ranganji, the chief guest for convocation, Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Chairman, Board of Governors, Sri Amit Khare, Secretary, Ministry of Education, members of the Board of Governors and Senate, faculty colleagues, staff, and students of the Institute, invitees, ladies and gentlemen. Aisa Tirupati ke Pratham Dikshant Samaroh mein aap sabka hardik swagat. I have great pleasure in presenting to you the Institute's report. Being the first convocation, I take this opportunity to highlight the important events during the first 5 years of our establishment. Let me begin by first congratulating the just graduated students. Dear students, you are the pioneer batch and you hold a special place in the Institute. The first convocation should have been a grand event, and for reasons known to all of you, we had to resort to the online event. But the spirit, the joyous feelings, and the pride cannot be mellowed. We do miss you all as much or even more than you missing the Institute. We all eagerly await for the day when we can all be ourselves like before on this campus. Aisa Tirupati was established by MHRD in February 2015 as the sixth member in the family of Aisas. Soon, the state government of Andhra Pradesh allocated 255 acres of land in Erpedu, 25 kilometers from Tirupati city, for building the permanent campus. The foundation stone of Aisa Tirupati, along with that of IIT and IIIT, were unveiled by the then Human Resource Minister, Srimati Smriti Zubin Irani, in March 2015. ISER Pune was asked by MHRD to be the mentor institute, and in my capacity as director of ISER Pune, I became the mentor director of ISER Tirupati. With the help of the government of Andhra Pradesh and local administration, Sri Rama Engineering College, where we are now located, was chosen as a transit campus to start the academic session from August 2015. The faculty, administrative, engineering, and IT staff from ISER Pune established the necessary infrastructure, classrooms, office at the transit campus in record time to enable the commencement of the academic session in August 2015 for the first batch of students, among whom 35 students have been just conferred the BS/MS degrees today. An important step was the passing of the Nitzer Amendment Act in 2017, which incorporated ISER Tirupati along with other ISERs as an institution of national importance. I was appointed as the first full-time director of ISER Tirupati, and I assumed the office in November 2017 after 11 years at ISER Pune. Immediately, the process for appointment of regular faculty and administrative staff began. With land available, the priority was to start the processes for campus construction, and by April 2018, the appointment of architect and the development of master plan was completed. In addition, the immediate construction of two hostels of 540 capacity and an integrated undergraduate teaching and experimental laboratory block began. Both these works are nearing completion, and the academic session from January 2021 for the first 2 years of BSMS program will be from the permanent campus. The DPR of the Institute was approved by the Union Cabinet in September 2018, and this paved the way to commence the process for construction of permanent campus as per the master plan. The construction work has been assigned to CPWD, and after going through the due processes, the work is likely to be awarded by middle of September. The funds for all construction and capital equipment is being efficiently dispersed by the ministry through Higher Education Funding Agency, HEFA. The institute started PhD program in 2017, post-BSc integrated PhD program in 2018, and postdoctoral program in 2019. At present, the institute has about 600 students, composing 426 BSMS students, 40 PhD students, 95 PhD students, and 39 postdoctoral fellows. The institute is administering more than 150 courses across different disciplines, and recently has introduced several new and unique courses, such as forensic science, data science, food science, and at the outset of COVID, a 2-credit course on pandemics was introduced in April this year. Courses with both lectures and training on ethics, plagiarism, IPR, safety, communication are compulsory, and the institute plans to start very soon courses in regulatory science, atmospheric and climate science, and pedagogy, science pedagogy. Most of these courses are also career-oriented. Creation of humanities and social science group is in progress and awaiting sanction for new faculty appointments. Many academic programs at ISERS by design are already aligned with NEP 2020. At ISER Tirupati, imparting knowledge, that is teaching, is synchronous with creation of knowledge, research, and its utilization application. Within a short span of 3 years of starting PhD and postdoctoral program, the faculty members from the institute have published close to 200 research papers in reputed international journals. Some of them include undergraduate students as authors. The institute has developed interdisciplinary strengths in the areas of disease biology, material science, plant sciences, energy science, soft matter physics, and algebraic mathematics, just to name a few. Our faculty have already received several professional recognitions. Professor Vijay Mohanan Pillai got CRSI gold medal and just recently was awarded the J.C. Bose Fellowship, CRSI bronze medal for Dr. Balaraman, and MRSI medal for Dr. Aravindan. Dr. Arun Kumar Bar and Dr. Swarup Rai Chowdhury have secured project under STARS scheme. Dr. Dilip Mampali received Joseph Mundasiri Award for Science Communication. Dr. Shiva Vallabha Prabhu was awarded Welcome Trust DBT Intermediate Fellowship, and Dr. Srinivas Shawali secured INYA's membership. Notably, two of our students have completed courses on contact tracing, so important these days, and have received international certificates. The institute has developed interactions with several national and international institutions for exchange of students, faculty, joint research collaborations. International collaborations include with Max Planck Society of Germany, University of Melbourne, Australia for research and pedagogy, University of Newcastle, Australia for energy materials, NCKU from Taiwan for biological sciences, ENS and CNRS in France, Erasmus for Raman Charpak and Eiffel programs. ISER Tirupati students team won gold medal at the iGEM global competition at Boston for their project in synthetic biology. Institute is drawing expertise from National Technological University, Singapore on learning management systems and education via flip classroom. ISER, along with the University of Melbourne, is initiating BSc blended program with Sri Venkateshwara University. Institute has organized several international conferences and collaborations with other professional societies. Topical conference of Indian Society of Atomic and Physics on Quantum Collisions in Confinement, International Biogeography Society of India, annual meeting of the Astronomical Society of India in February 2020, which had about 325 delegates, out of it 53% were student participants, and International Conference on Chemical Biology, workshop on bioacoustics with Cornell University. Tirupati is the only city which has both an IIT and an ISER, and this has enabled several joint academic and research activities. The students from both institutes can share credited courses. Faculty are involved in teaching courses across the two institutes. Just recently, a week ago, the two institutes jointly launched a Center for Atomic and Molecular and Optical Sciences and Technology, CHEMOST, to address the exciting basic science challenges and applications and opportunities in the area of quantum technologies. Establishment of a joint ISER, IIT and Amar Raja Battery Center for Energy is under progress, involving Amar Raja batteries. Similarly, IISER and IIT are partnering with Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeeth, now a central university at Tirupati, to establish joint teaching and research in Indian traditional knowledge system. With SWIMS, ISER is involved in application of mass spectra for rapid diagnosis of cancer. Sir, I'm extremely happy to inform you all that ISER Tirupati is now establishing a COVID-19 testing center, which will become operational from 15 September 2020. Conscious of our societal responsibilities, the institute's faculty and students are involved in several outreach activities, spreading science among schools in and around Tirupati with Unnati team, reaching out to underprivileged and rural students. These students are also often invited to visit the institute. The institute also engages with teachers on pedagogic issues. In collaboration with Agastya Foundation, our faculty are engaging with highly enabled students from Navodaya schools to spot their extraordinary and unusual talents to accelerate growth of their scientific abilities. In this context, I must thank Shri Amit Kare, who suggested this kind of a scheme under the government scheme of Dhruva. The current pandemic situation has given the institute new opportunities to develop innovative online teaching methods, learning management systems, and student evaluations. However, many students are handicapped by lack of access to reliable internet, laptops, and poor electricity supply. The country needs to address these fundamental issues of accessibility to technology to enable spreading mass education and promote online teaching. This has been an important limitation for the success of online teaching and evaluation in most of the institutes. The motto of the institute, creating infinite possibilities, sums up the institute's vision, mission and aspirations to make learning at ISER Tirupati a joyous experience for students and hold their hands to enable them stretch beyond their limits for full realization of their talent, which indeed is an important purpose of education itself. We are very grateful to Honorable HRM Sri Ramesh Nishank Pokhriyalji for his constant inspiration and energetic support to ISERS in charting our future course. And sir, we assure you that ISERS will strive hard to fulfill your aspirations of National Education Policy 2020. I would like to place on record our deep appreciation to officers from Ministry of Education, Board of Governors, Finance Committee, Building Works Committee, and the Senate for their continuous advice and support. We thank all the well-wishers of the Institute for their role in various capacities in shaping up the Young Institute. Finally, on behalf of the Institute, I sincerely thank Dr. Kasturi Rangan, Professor Ashutosh Sharma, and Sri Amit Kare for honoring us by their presence and inspirational guidance on this historic day. My sincere appreciation to each one of you for your participation in the event. Namaskar and Dhanyavad.
I now request Shri Amit Kareji, Secretary, Department of Higher Education, Ministry of Education, Government of India, and Member, Board of Governors, to present his remarks.
Respected Dr. Kasturi Ranganji, Chairperson of the Board of Governors, Professor Ashutosh Sharmaji, Director, ISER Tirupati, Professor Ganesh, all faculty members, all staff members, Mr. Randeep Roy and Jalaja Madhusudanan, who received gold medals today, and all the graduating students. Let me start by congratulating all the students who have received their degrees. A big appreciation for all of you for being the first batch to graduate from this prestigious institute. Even more appreciation and congratulation to the gurus, that is Professor Ganesh, all faculty members, all staff members, because they have worked day and night over the last 5 years to set up the institute and to see that this first batch graduates today. Indeed, it is a matter of great pride for our ministry that the first batch is graduating today from ICER Tirupati. And the way this institute has developed, I must place on record my appreciation for Professor Ganesh. He has been instrumental in development of ICER Pune, and now as the founder director of ICER Tirupati, he has again established a new institute, that is ICER Tirupati. I was really glad to hear the initiatives taken by ICER Pune, particularly the collaboration that they have with other institutes such as IIT Tirupati and Sanskrit University at Tirupati. In fact, respected Dr. Kasturi Ranganji, who has drafted the National Education Policy 2020, which is a revolutionary transformation in the field of education sector, has emphasized many changes, but most important and significant is to have multidisciplinarity. And the experiment that Professor Ganesh has already started at Tirupati to have joint programs with IIT, to have programs with Sanskrit University, to look into the traditional knowledge systems, I think it is a great work which is being done, and more so ahead of time, that it is just in line with the National Education Policy drafted by Dr. Kasturi Ranganji. As I said, this is a matter of great pride for the ministry that this institute has come up so well. I would like to thank Professor Ganesh and all the team members. He has built up a great team at Tirupati. All of them deserve appreciation, applause for the great work that they have done in setting up this institute. And I wish all the best to them and also to the graduating students. Thank you very much.
Yeah, so I would like to thank Shri Amit Kare for his valuable remarks. And now I request Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Chairperson, Board of Governors, to deliver his speech and introduce the chief guest.
Good morning. Friends, I am delighted at the opportunity to address a gathering of bright young minds in the first convocation of ICER Tirupati. Let me begin by extending my warmest greetings to the distinguished chief guest, Dr. Kasturi Rangan, to Shri Amit Kare, Secretary, Department of Higher Education, Professor K.N. Ganesh, Director, ICER, Dr. Mohan Kumar, Registrar, distinguished members of the governing board, faculty, staff, graduating students, their families, and other friends and invitees. Friends, it's a wonderful day in the beautiful holy city of Tirupati, a campus filled with energetic minds, ready to meet the future with optimism and positivity. I congratulate all the graduating students on this euphoric day that marks the dawn of your professional journey. You make your institute, your professors, your parents, your friends, and your country mighty proud of you. Let us take a moment to appreciate their contributions. Remember, if we do not know how to thank properly, our debts remain forever. Being the pioneer batch of students, you will always have a special place in the history of the institute. You will set the standards for the coming generations. Whatever you do in the future, you will always be known as graduates of ISA Tirupati. Never forget your alma mater and remain proud of the rich tradition that we inaugurate today as its ambassadors. I know I am mighty proud of my association with the Institute, its fast progress, and its limitless potential in the years and decades to come. Friends, some of you will receive medals and prizes today, some of you have, but no matter what your grades or GPA or medals have been, all of you remain shining stars in that special corner of our hearts. No matter what your grades, all of you will contribute to science, to society, and to nation in extraordinary ways. Make no mistakes about it. About ICER, we already learned about the beginning and the history of ICER from the director. ICERs have traveled a great distance of quantity and quality within a short span of 14 years. The founding directors, faculty, students, and staff of ICERs have worked really hard to build the brand ICER. ICERs now figure in the top 50 of NIRF ranking and top 10 sometimes of Nature Index among the Indian institutions. ICER Tirupati started in 2015 under the excellent mentorship of ICER Pune. I know that research and teaching infrastructure was set up even in the transit campus. The permanent campus construction is under rapid progress, and by Jan 2021, the first 2 years of BSMS program will be run from the permanent campus. There are great opportunities for ICER Tirupati. A unique advantage of ICER Tirupati is the presence of adjoining IIT and other academic institutes in the city, such as Sri Venkateshwara University, Padmavati Women University, Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeeth. This was already talked about by director, and this advantage will result in strong networking. And soon the Temple Town will also be known as a premier educational hub. I'm happy to learn that ICER and IIT already jointly established a center for atomic optical molecular physics and its applications in quantum technology. I may add the same science and technology, and DST is in the process of launching a 8,000 crore rupee national mission on quantum technology and its applications. So we are indeed totally future ready in getting to join the cutting edge science and technology, the global science and technology. Thus, ICER Tirupati is well placed to turn the basic research into several applications in network collaboration with neighboring institutions. Why is networking important? Remember, while competition remains a central model in academic research, real problem solving in health, energy, water, transport, food, environment, climate, sustainability, communication, manufacturing, etc., require multidisciplinary cooperation. We are in the age of online teaching. The times of virus have thrown up new challenges in all spheres of life and education. The in-person classroom experience for students is being transformed to online learning and teaching. This is the new normal. Every new challenge should be used as a new opportunity. Do treat online courses with the same respect, commitment, and interest as the real courses. At home, create your own regular study space. Eliminate distractions during online classes. Interact with your academic advisors on figuring out how to learn best. Not everyone learns the same way. You can create your own study groups. In addition to effectively navigate online learning, it's also a good time to understand the virtues of lifelong learning, which is possible only by self-learning. Learning is too important to be outsourced only to your teachers. I often half jokingly say that bad teachers are really good teachers, because they bring to us the importance and urgency of self-learning. In short, do develop the discipline for self-learning, which is all the learning there actually is and will ever be. faculty teaching and research may have to take new detours, explore new avenues. We may learn to adapt to new teaching styles, effective use of blackboard, compelling body language, face-to-face contact, some virtues of classical teaching. These need to be now more than compensated by other means. Content management and delivery need to be tailored as attention span at home may be less. There are indeed plenty of opportunities for a teacher to leverage technology for effective teaching. Plus, there is also a bonus in online teaching. This is a joke. You don't see bored or dozing students anymore, which can be highly demotivating for a sincere teacher. So there is always some blessings in every change. Friends, no matter if I'm a teacher or a student or whatever, change is forever the only constant. And the future is full of exponential and disruptive challenges in many forms, as sustainable development, rise of intelligent machines, environment and climate, resource constraints, and so on. Let us get comfortable in negotiating, adapting, responding, and even engineering the change. The time passages of the virus have taught us many compelling reasons of learning and doing science. Until 3-4 months ago, we imported ventilators, we imported diagnostic kits, even PPEs and masks. Today, we have the best world-class or better COVID-19 related products and technologies manufactured in India with speed and scale. We have 3 promising vaccines going into advanced clinical trials. How did that happen? Why couldn't it happen 5 or 10 years ago? I think there are many lessons we have learned here that we can take forward with us in doing science and technology in the future. It was a clear and present and shared purpose that allowed a spontaneous coming together of our academia, R&D labs, industry, startups, PSUs, and the government to solve the problems. Problem solving requires a seamless connect of the entire knowledge ecosystem, from basic sciences to applied sciences to technology to product development to design to prototyping to testing to standards, manufacturing to startups and to industry, to financial support to procurement policies, to market to society. It requires a huge spirit of cooperation and teamwork. It requires that push of knowledge matches the pull of knowledge consuming systems, which is industry and society. Our Prime Minister has given a clarion call for an Atmanirbhar Bharat, a self-sufficient India, which can effectively address its own needs by producing the global quality products. In addition to cooperative science and technology, there are also deep cultural, behavioral, and societal aspects to Atmanirbhar Bharat. Some of these are Atmavishwas, self-confidence, Atmasamman, self-respect, and Atmachintan, introspection. These are the vital aspects of holistic education and beyond. I am sure ICERs understand the power of positivity in producing the top scientists who are not afraid to take risks, who are leaders rather than followers, who are empowered to do profound and even disruptive research, disruptive science, rather than incremental science. Friends, the role of higher education is not only to cultivate intellect, but also to ignite the imagination and creativity and empathy. It has to create scholars and leaders and not just academics, transfer values and not just information, and prepare you for a career and not just for a job. You are fortunate to have studied in an institution which has provided a broad-based educational experience, making all of this is possible. Friends, I repeat, our challenges are clear and present. There is no time for sloth and being contented. Here is a light-hearted saying: if you want to change the world, do it while you are young. In fact, do it while you are single. Once you are married, you cannot even change a TV channel. Friends, we are at the end. Let me quickly run through a couple of things that I try to do not always successfully, but I always share it with friends. Be curious. Feed well not only the body, but the mind and the heart also every single day. Don't confuse success with excellence. Both success and failures are transitory. It is our sensitivity to the little joys and sorrows of the world around us that make our journey have any meaning at all. I wish each one of the graduating students all the very best again in whatever path that you take from now on. May this day in your life be a special one, a significant one, and the start of a beautiful journey. Friends, I wish you a path with a heart for the journey that you start now. Live long and prosper. Jai Hind. I would now introduce our chief guest for today, Dr. K. Kasturi Rangan, and would make a brief introduction about him. Of course, he needs no introduction. We always say that in all the functions about chief guest, but for him, it's really true. So let me very quickly go through his introduction. Dr. Krishna Swami Kasturi Rangan is presently Chairman, Governing Board, Inter-University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics, Pune, Chancellor, Central University of Rajasthan, Chairperson, NIIT University, Neem Rana, Member, Atomic Energy Commission, Emeritus Professor at National Institute of Advanced Studies at Bangalore, and Honorary Distinguished Advisor, ISRO. He received his doctorate in Experimental High Energy Astronomy in 71 from Physical Research Laboratory, Ahmedabad, and has published more than 200 papers in astrophysics, space science, and space applications. He was chairman of Indian Space Research Organization for a period of nearly 10 years from 94 to 2003. He was a director of National Institute of Advanced Studies, Bangalore from 2003 to 9, and served as a member, Rajya Sabha, and a member of the erstwhile Planning Commission 2009 to 14. Dr. Kasturi Rangan led the Karnataka Knowledge Commission as its chairman. More recently, 2017-2018, he was the chairman of the committee that drafted the new national education policy, which has been a huge undertaking and would continue to make its impact felt over decades to come. Dr. Kasturi Rangan was a Satish Dhawan Chair of Engineering Eminence, instituted by Indian National Academy of Engineering. He is a fellow of all the four major science and engineering academies of India. Among others, he is a member of the International Astronomical Union, fellow of the World Academy of Sciences, honorary fellow of the Cardiff University, UK, and academician of the Pontifical Academy of Sciences, Vatican City. Dr. Kasturi Rangan is the only Indian to be conferred the honorary membership of the International Academy of Astronautics, besides being his vice president. Dr. Kasturi Rangan has won several awards, both internationally and nationally, as you can well imagine. Some of the notable ones among them are Brock Medal of International Society of Photogrammetry and Remote Sensing, Alan D. Emil Memorial Award of the International Astronomical Federation, Theodore Von Karman Award by International Academy of Astronautics, Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Award in Engineering in 81, Aryabhatta Medal by Indian National Science Academy, Rathindra Puraskar by Vishwa Bharati, Desi Kotam Award of Vishwa Bharati, Hari Om Ashram Prerit Senior Scientist Award, Physical Lab, to name a few. He has been conferred honorary doctorates from 26 universities and research institutions. He is a recipient of the highest civilian honors, including Padma Shri in 82, Padma Bhushan in 92, Padma Vibhushan in 2000. What a great way to enter the new millennium, sir. This is so fantastic, wonderful. From the President of India and the Rajyotsav Prashasti from Government of Karnataka and the Officer of the Legion d'Honneur by the President of French Republic, France. So it's truly fantastic to have you with us here for the very first convocation of ICER Tirupati, the fantastic, beautiful, holy town. Sir, I request now you to deliver the convocation address.
Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Chairperson, Board of Governors, Indian Institute of Science, Education and Research, Tirupati. My very valued associate, Sri Amit Khareji, Mem Secretary, Ministry of Education. Professor K.N. Ganesh, Director, ICER, Tirupati. Dr. C.P. Mohan Kumar, Registrar. Members of the Board of Governors and Senate, faculty members and supportive staff, esteemed guests, my dear students, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, let me thank the chairperson, members of the Board of Governors, members of the Senate, and the director for this honor done to me in inviting to deliver the first convocation address of the Indian Institute of Science, Education and Research, Tirupati. I use this opportunity to greet all the members of the academic and supportive staff who, in a sense, are the part of the pioneering team shaping the future of this promising institution. I'm delighted to note that ICER Tirupati is being mentored and guided at the highest level by none other than Professor Ashutosh Sharma, a scientist of great repute, a very popular teacher, who has further established himself as a key visionary to promote science and technology research in this country in its multiple dimensions. Besides being a respected academician, the chairperson has wide-ranging interests, including in education. More recently, he confided this to me, maybe unofficial. He has come out with a very unique suggestion to examine how multiple institutions of the Department of Science and Technology could become a part of a strong conglomerate of higher education and research through appropriate reconfiguration of their roles and structures, something very timely and important in the context of strengthening the overall higher education in this country. I'm very happy to see my friend, Sri Amit Khareji today here, Secretary, Ministry of Education, who is also a member of the Board of Governors of this institute, and who has just now shared a few thoughtful words about the future of higher education, particularly within the framework of the National Education Policy 2020. I should particularly highlight the critical role. This is the first time I'm talking, giving a convocation address after the policy has been approved, and I have been very closely working with Amit Khareji, and that's why I want to share these thoughts about Amit Khareji to all of you, that he played a very critical role in moving this policy at the highest levels of the government, first through the conduct of several consultations and reviews, and subsequently working with the Honorable Minister of Education, and finally with the Honorable Prime Minister himself. It's pertinent to mention here that Sri Amit Khare deserves a lot of credit for the speed with which the entire processes were carried out, and bringing his own wide-ranging professional knowledge in the subject of education to guide crucial steps at appropriate times. It's timely at this juncture to inform on this erudite audience that our Honorable Prime Minister had several sittings with the experts on this particular policy. And his own ideas were extremely interesting. He made several innovative and pragmatic suggestions, both on school and higher education. Further, the Honorable Prime Minister, in his recent address at the All India Conclave of Indian Vice Chancellors, declared that the NEP 20 will be now onwards the policy of the government, and that no efforts should be spared to implement the same. I am saying all this because these are all the later developments after the policy was submitted, and Prime Minister's own role in trying to review, and most importantly, declaring to the nation about the ownership of this policy and the seriousness which it will be pursued. Professor Ganesh, who is now the founding director of ICER Tirupati, had a very illustrious career as an academic, researcher, and an institution builder. As the founding director of the ICER Pune, he brought up this institution to a position of preeminence, and for over more than a decade took several innovative initiatives that transformed this center of erudition into one of the front-ranking institutions among the family of ISERs. I can say without hesitation, the originality and the creativity that he brought to bear in shaping the evolution of ISER Pune certainly give the family of ISERs a brand name for science education and research, both nationally and internationally. It's therefore very fortunate that such an experienced visionary is now heading the ISER Tirupati, which is destined to reach highest levels of excellence and erudition under his leadership. I can already see this in the very report that he gave of the last 5 years, which by itself speaks volumes of the diversity and the extraordinary efforts that he and the institute has put in trying to take it to the next level within such a short period. In PhDs, strong academic programs, paper productions, inter-institutional activities are some of the key elements of the things that he is trying to foster with respect to this institute's role in the future. I'm also elaborating these three key names associated with ISER Tirupati. I want to say this with Sri Achyuto Sarmaji, with respect to Amit Khare, as well as to Ganesh, that they are not only people who are known for their intrinsic stature and credentials, they can also serve, if I may say, the role models for the many of you, my dear young students who are graduating today, because they had their own career, they had the very way of looking at it, their professionalism were always at the highest level, they attached a lot of importance to quality and other kinds of characteristics which are very critical in the modern context of pursuing any kind of profession. I also use this opportunity to compliment the academic staff. Each of you have a critical role, I should say, in the evolutionary phase of this institute, besides, of course, ushering an era of transformation called by the imperatives of the 21st knowledge century, enunciated appropriately within the framework of the national education policy. My dear young friends, first let me congratulate all of you, the graduating students of the day, and I am sure you have a great future coming out of your alma mater. And I'm sure that each one of you will make a mark for yourself in the years to come in a country, in a global context, where such challenges are met only with the best traditions of quality and reliability, and also heritage, which your institute has imbibed in you. As the first group of students graduating from this institute, you are in a sense pioneers, and thus torchbearers of an institution poised to reach high level of achievements in the coming years. Further, I can also expect this institution to be the beneficiary of the rich tradition and heritage of its sister institutes in the ISER family, spread in the different parts of the country, having transformed the life of more than 15,000 students in the recent times with diverse background. Tirupati, called the spiritual capital of Andhra Pradesh, is one of the major holy cities of our country, being the abode of Lord Venkateshwara. Apart from Sri Lord Venkateshwara's temple, Tirupati is also home to centuries of temples whose architectural splendors have a heavenly aura, finding their mention in Vedas and Puranas. The Vijayanagara rulers, the Pallavas, the Cholas were all patrons of this holy city. Tirupati is one among the 100 cities which have been selected to be developed as a smart city under the Smart Cities Mission of the Government of India. Being the most visited heritage city in the world, tourism forms a major economic component. Tirupati is also a major medical hub to the surrounding cities and is home to many educational institutions and universities. This institute, located at the foothills of Tirupati, provides a holistic environment of peace, tranquility, enchanting ecosystem, combined with a divine force that attracts people from all walks of life, both from different parts of the country as well as from the world. Such a unique setting certainly will provide the necessary ingredients for the inspirational minds of the students to bring out their highest level of creativity and originality. The academic staff will find this location most ideal to perform academic activities at the peak of the excellence. The kind and ever-caring Lord Venkateshwara bestows his benign blessings on one and all, standing majestically atop the sacred seven hills with his consorts. His kind-hearted disposition for the well-being of this institution is sure to influence the future growth and evolution of ISER Tirupati and transform it into a world-renowned center of knowledge and erudition. The most recent significant development about it the director mentioned could also add considerable value to the performance of ISER Tirupati. The decision to locate IIT and IIIT in the neighborhood, thereby increasing the potential outcome of each of these institutions through synergy in academic and related activities. I'm very happy to see the director mentioning about already the linkages that are already going on between these institutions. It's refreshing to see the agenda that ISER Tirupati has drawn up at its academic program and its linkages to NEP 2020. Some of the important components of the institute proposes to introduce in the forthcoming year itself includes placing emphasis on holistic and multidisciplinary education with flexibility of subjects, provision for multiple entry and exit, particularly in the four-year undergraduate program, a postgraduate program with 1 or 2 years or integrated BSMS, doing away with MPhil, and credit transfer facility for academic credits. And even though some of this may go beyond the first year, the resolve of the institute to regard to its implementation is in no doubt. I'm extremely happy to note ISER Tirupati is working towards a model to transform itself into a research intensive or teaching intensive university. Noting that the policy does emphasize the need to have considerable attention to language development and also awareness of the Indian cultural knowledge systems, the institute is looking at appropriate institutional mechanisms to realize the same. This was mentioned both by the chairman as well as by the director. I'm also to note with satisfaction that review that the institute has done towards the induction of technology for education. In this connection, ISER Tirupati could host a center of excellence in educational technology and work closely with the proposed National Educational Technological Forum, NTF. Such a forum is expected to provide independent, evidence-based advice to central and state government agencies on the use of technology, building related intellectual and institutional capacities, identify strategic thrust areas related to educational technology, besides articulating new directions for research and innovations. I'm sure this institution, hosting such a center of excellence and working closely with NETF, could provide new and innovative inputs that would make introduction of technologies into education, assuring among others robustness and resilience. The vision of India's new educational system has been crafted to ensure that it touches the life of each and every citizen, consistent with their needs and necessities, besides creating a just and equitable society. The approach is to create a new system aligned with aspirational goals of 21st century education, while remaining consistent with India's value systems and ethos. The policy, that is the NEP 2020, provides an integrated yet flexible approach to education. Further, it has kept the interconnectedness of the various phases of education in mind and how the same will enable continuity, coherence, and processes to ultimately realize an end-to-end educational roadmap for the country. Major emphasis is given in the policy to the aspect of holistic and multidisciplinary education as a foundational component of the undergraduate at the undergraduate level. The undergraduate level will also ultimately provide a holistic approach to education by slowly bringing in professional and vocational education into the mainstream education. At the postgraduate level, one of the key recommendations relates to the strengthening of the research in the university system. The policy recommends the creation of the National Research Foundation for this purpose, about which I shall elaborate a little more later on. a light but tight mechanism for regulation is envisaged under this policy, and also the corresponding institutional methods, providing a more cohesive structure for higher educational institution in the context of teaching and research, ensuring increased autonomy and empowered governance and effective leadership are the other features of the policy. On the whole, the policy aims at the development of the 21st century skills for students while giving enough flexibility in making choices consistent with the dynamics of a modern knowledge society. At this point, I would like to share some of my thoughts in the context of the importance of the holistic and multidisciplinary education with focus on undergraduate education. This concept, sometimes also referred to as liberal education in the contemporary discussions, has its origin in India's age-old idea of liberal arts dating back to almost 14,000 years. In the modern day social and economic landscape, this age-old Indian concept is now finding recognition in a new form. As per our policy, and I'm quoting this from the policy, liberal education explores the remarkable relationships that exist among the sciences and humanities, mathematics and arts, medicine and physics, etc., and more generally, the surprising unity of all fields of human endeavor, unquote. A comprehensive liberal education develops all capacities of human beings, intellectual, aesthetics, social, physical, emotional, and moral in an integrated manner. In a specific context, I would like to bring in the importance of the knowledge related to arts, crafts, architecture, and aesthetics as a part of science and engineering education. For example, it's often commented that India produces very competent scientists and engineers, but falls short of being great innovators. Steve Jobs, former founder of Apple, I don't have to introduce further, was famous for his ideas on what makes products successful. According to him, the secret was to bring top-notch aesthetics with top-notch science and engineering. He himself is known to have said about why the Macintosh computer revolutionized engineering. And I quote, "I think part of what made Macintosh great was that the people working on it were musicians and poets, artists and zoologists and historians, who also happened to be the best computer sciences in the engineering and engineers in the world." I'm sure this institute, with its plans for bringing multidisciplinarity and holisticity to the various courses, could be in the forefront of creating world-class innovators and producing seminal ideas coming out of a thinking process that cuts across disciplines by marrying science, education with arts and humanities and other fields. If one were to look at the present trends of job recruitment, especially in the Western world, it's of relevance to note that many employers, especially in the high-tech areas, emphasize the need for learning outcomes associated with integrated learning, such as critical thinking, communication skills, teamwork, and abilities for lifelong learnings. With the rapid strides in technology that include artificial intelligence, machine learning, robotics, and communications, graduates will need transferable and uniquely human skills to be able to adaptively and continuously learn to work with and alongside new technologies. It's also important to recognize that each person entering the job market today will look forward not only to several jobs, but also to several careers in his or in her working life. As India aspires to grow and sustain a large and vibrant economy and uplifting its society, one of the key elements to a successful realization is to have a robust ecosystem of research and innovation. Chairman mentioned about this in quite a bit of detail as to what the strategy for this in India is. The present inadequacies in this context are very much evident through the low number of researchers in India per lakh of population. Is often quoted 15 compared to, this is per lakh, 15 compared to 423 in US or 825 in Israel and so on. This in turn has implications with regard to the number of publications and most importantly, patent applications and industrial growth involving indigenous technology. The problem is very much acute in the university system. Even as I recognize the increasing prominence to research and its outcomes in institutions like ICERS, IITs, and other institutions of national eminence. I considering that we have nearly 900 universities, there is a sense of urgency in boosting the research capability in our higher educational institutions, particularly in the university systems. In order to seed, nurture, grow, and transform universities into full-fledged research centers of excellence, the NEP 2020 has recommended the creation of a national research foundation. It will support research programs in sciences, technologies, social sciences, arts and humanities, and many other areas. Institutions like ICERS, besides taking advantage of NRF, would also have the responsibility to mentoring neighboring institutions towards establishing research capabilities. Dear students, a word about what is in store for you. When you step out of this institution, you have to face the world which is full of challenges and uncertainties. In the very heart of challenges, there are hidden opportunities. Further, the progress of your life, you will certainly come across hurdles, handicaps, and failures. I can only advise that for everything you do, have a strong conviction, have the persistence to follow through your conviction, and have the courage to face failures. I still remember the events in ISRO related to the failures of two augmented satellite launch vehicles. Even though a sense of despondency overtook us initially, we did not allow this setback to override our resolve to succeed. I should say the critical analysis and the in-depth assessment of the problems we made and the technology and quality issues that we addressed really paved the way for the success of the present generation of PSLVs and GSLVs. I should mention, PSLV is one of the most successful launch vehicles anywhere in this world for this category of launchers. In analyzing the failures, we got an insight into the inadequacies and the marginal nature of our initial design. Further, our courage of conviction made us work with redoubled vigor to succeed, which we did. I've often felt that life can teach you more from a failure than through success. Notwithstanding the considerations of professionalism, challenges, opportunities, risk, and so on, you need to explore the limitless frontier of knowledge throughout your life. My dear friends, the path to great achievements and success will put enormous demands on you and call upon you to bring to bear the highest degree of professionalism inspired by being a part of a fast-changing knowledge ecosystem. This in turn will imply continuous updating of your knowledge and thus making the process of learning a continuous one. The ancient Indian wisdom reflected in the following Subhashita sloka is apt to the situation, and I quote, Acharya padamadatte padam shishya swamedaya padam sabra brahmacharipya padam kalakramena cha. A student learns one quarter from his master. The second quarter accrues from one's own intelligence. The third from fellow students. Time and experience confers the last quarter, unquote. In conclusion, I would like to emphasize that as inheritors of a society which blossomed up great values for life and a deep concern for human development, you should intensely aspire for deepening and broadening your knowledge, learn to experience the power of collective teamwork, and always be guided by higher values which you believe in. In all this lies before you, may God grant you wisdom, success, and true sense of fulfillment of your cherished ideals and goals. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring convocation address to our young graduates. To take back memories of your participation in the convocation function, we would like to present to you a memento. So we will send the memento to your office. The director and chairperson of the Senate, the director and chairperson of the Senate will now administer the exhortation to the graduating students.
Dear graduating students, direct your knowledge and intellectual attainment in the pursuit of truth. Be honest in thought, deed, and word while discharging duties of your profession. Devote your time for the well-being of society and respect the dignity of the individual. Uphold the values of integrity and scholarship at all times. Be worthy of your alma mater and acclaim its dignity and honor. Strive for the unity, integrity, and progress of our country and mankind at large. Thank you.
I now request Dr. Mohan Kumar, Registrar ISA Tirupati, to propose the oath of thanks.
Good afternoon, everybody. As we have come to the conclusion of the historic first convocation of the Institute, it is my privilege and duty to acknowledge and express our gratitude to many people who have been a part of the journey since 2015, culminating in this solemn function today. Dr. K. Kasturirangan, our chief guest of today's function, has been an inspiration to many of us, and his convocation address has put in perspective the National Education Plan and also to the students the importance of values, concern for human development, deepening knowledge, and teamwork. Sir, we thank you for accepting our invitation to be the chief guest, despite the demands on your time, and for delivering a truly inspirational convocation address. Thank you, sir. Our chairman, Professor Ashutosh Sharma, has always been of strong support to the Institute, constantly guiding and motivating us as chairperson of the Board of Governors. Sir, your presence and your thoughts for the graduating students is most appreciated, and we thank you for the same. We thank Sri Amit Kareji, Secretary in the Ministry of Education, for sparing his valuable time to give his remarks on this momentous occasion in spite of his several official commitments. Thank you, sir. Sri Kareji's team of Dr. Chandrasekhar Kumar, Joint Secretary, Mrs. Darshana Dabral, Financial Advisor, Ms. Shweta Rao, Deputy Director in charge of ISERS, and other officials in the ministry have always been a source of constant support and have been and will continue to be active partners in the journey of ISER Tirupati, and we gratefully acknowledge their support. Professor Ganesh, our inspirational director, has been instrumental first as a mentor director and then as the director in establishing this institute and ensuring that the academic programs commenced in record time in 2015, leading now to this first convocation. Our sincere thanks to the director for being there for all of us, the faculty, staff, and students, whenever we needed his guidance and advice in planning this convocation to the minutest detail. Thank you, sir. Our special thanks and good wishes are due in particular to the students of the BSMS 2015 batch for their choice of ISER Tirupati. While they could have had other options in 2015, they chose a new institute and have done us all proud by successfully completing their academic programs. Congratulations to all of you. I would also like to compliment the parents and guardians of all the students who have joined us virtually and thought it appropriate to choose ISER Tirupati for the awards and for the confidence reposed in the institute. The faculty of the institute needs special mention for having strived hard in graduating the first batch despite the challenges posed in the process of setting up a new institute. I would like to make a special mention of one person who deserves a special mention here, for she is the one who has meticulously worked on the minute details of this convocation, right from the degrees, the designing of the convocation attire, the medal, the invitation, the brochure, the program, and whatnot. Professor Ambika, thank you, madam. You have, as always, now set the standards and the path for this institute in conducting the academics and the convocation. Our deans of faculty and the dean of research and development and the associate deans need special mention for their support to the students and the administration in organizing this prestigious event. Our thanks are also due to the Government of Andhra Pradesh, senior officials of the Government of Andhra Pradesh Department of Higher Education and the Health Department, and the district administration led by the collector, the municipal commissioner, TUDA, and the TTD for their cooperation and support. This entire machinery of the institute would not move smoothly and effortlessly, but for the dedicated and wholehearted work put in by the whole team of administrative and technical staff, the untiring efforts of Mr. Inderpreet Singh Kohli and the committed teams in administration, IT, academics, engineering, purchase, accounts, and the technical staff in the departments. A special word of appreciation and thanks to the housekeeping and security staff who ensured that everything functions normally, even during these abnormal and challenging times of the pandemic. The members of various committees of the institute who were a constant source of support to the students and the administration need a special mention. I also acknowledge the contribution of people who had served the institute in the beginning but are not with us and have moved on, like Mr. Chaman Mehta, who anchored the academic office for 5 years till he moved on for better prospects. Finally, I have reserved the acknowledgement of some very special people till the end, because they are truly inspiring and committed people from ISER Tirupati's mentoring institute, ISER Pune. The director of ISER Pune and the registrar, Colonel Rajsekhar, and their outstanding and committed team and many others' efforts are acknowledged, for it is their hard work and unrelenting efforts that ensured that ISER Tirupati started functioning in record time from the transit campus, and that all required personnel and systems were in place for this pioneering batch of students and the faculty to settle down and go about their business. A big thank you to all of you and your team. I must also thank the offices of our chief guest, Dr. Kasturi Rangan, the secretary in the chairman board of governors office, and the secretaries in our secretary ministry of education's office, who helped us coordinate and deliver this virtual convocation online. I would like to once again thank one and all who joined us in this journey and continue to travel with us. Thank you. I now request our chairman, Professor Ashutosh Sharma, to declare the convocation closed.
I declare the first convocation of ISER Tirupati closed.
I request everyone to please rise for the national anthem.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात मराठा द्रविड़ उत्कल गंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उत्सल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे, तव शुभ आशीष मांगे, गाहे तव जय गाथा, जन गण मंगल गायक, जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता, जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your participation in the convocation. All are requested to please remain standing till the academic procession leaves the hall. Making the first convocation ceremony a grand success. Have a good day.